So, first question that I have is just a basic one, and I want to ask Stuart this question, and if any of the rest of you want to chime in, that'd be great as well. So, people here have sat through a whole day of great apologetics, great information, and now they want to go into their families and the marketplace and into their places of work and have these kind of conversations with people who are not believers. But they might will likely find that the conversations they think they're going to have are not like they thought they were, right? Like the conversations in your mind that you have in apologetics conference don't really happen all the time with your neighbor over the backyard fence. So how would you encourage these people to live this out and to be a witness in their communities, knowing now what they know after today?
Thank you. Well, it's really been a joy to be here. And I remember when I was preparing teams that used to go into Eastern Europe during the communist years, when we would send them in as just as tourists, essentially, and some of them were students and afraid a little bit of being in a communist country and unsure what would happen. And one of the things we always encouraged them was pray for divine appointments. You know, really pray. And I mean, Blackaby taught us that you should pray with your eyes open. Once you pray, keep your eyes and see what God is going to do. So I think in the marketplace of the university, I think if we do that, we start getting an expectation. Just say, Lord, if there's someone I can, you know, have a conversation with or I can show love to, I think we shouldn't put ourselves under such heavy duress, but to take it very naturally, just see what God does. But if you do make it a habit of praying, then you do need to keep your eyes open so that sometimes when the presentations come, you don't muff it or, you know, walk away from it. But always be ready just to talk. And, you know, I think time and time again, you'll see God bring people there. And often it can start with just asking simple questions, not loaded Christian questions, but just showing love, kindness, asking people how they are. Many of the conversations, I think all of us get into, come out of just a normal conversation that then segues into something. Because once it touches a point of pain or sorrow, even happiness, then you've got a place that you can bridge off from.